Hello, everybody. Welcome to our fourth Christians in Education bite-sized message. It's the 1st of March. I literally cannot believe it is the 1st of March today. When we think back to a year ago, did we ever think we'd be having the year that we've just had? And I don't think anyone would have predicted that. So sharing a message with us today is the Rev'd Emma Ham-Riche, who is the assistant curate at St. Mary's in East Preston. She used to serve on the City Mission Schools team alongside me. So she's a friend of the mission and of the Off the Fence Schools team as well. So be blessed by what you hear today.
During the first national lockdown on Radio 4, the Today programme, some of the BBC News' best known voices offered their favourite poems of comfort and hope and talked about the importance of those words in their lives. Now, Fergal Keane, who's one of the BBC's foreign correspondents, read a poem from a book called Benedictus, a book of blessings by John O'Donoghue. The poem was called This is the Time to Be Slow. These are the opening lines from that poem. This is the time to be slow. Lie low to the wall until the bitter weather passes. Whatever today has thrown at you, whatever today may hold for you, take some time to be slow. Find that time to low lie to the wall. In Psalm 46, verse 10, we read, Be still and know that I am God. So find some time today to be still. Let's take a moment now to pause and to pray. And if it helps, close your eyes and perhaps take a few deep breaths. This prayer is based on Psalm 46, verse 10. In fact, it uses that very simple line, Be still and know that I am God. Let's pray. Be still and know that I am God. Be still and know that I am. Be still and know. Be still. Be. Amen. Poem that Fergal Keane read continues like this. Try as best you can not to let the wire brush of doubt scrape from your heart all sense of yourself and your hesitant light. Whenever you feel that happening, find some time to be slow. The poem ends like this. If you remain generous, time will come good, and you will find your feet again on fresh pastures of promise, where the air will be kind and blushed with beginning. Amen.